In Greek, there were two types of time. First is chronos. That's where we get the word chronological. That's why we have calendars. We have 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in an hour, 24 hours in a day, right? 30 days in a month, 12 months in a year. We did it so chronologically. That's why we have things like this, right? Diba? Meron tayong ganito because we make sure we never miss an appointment. But truly, in God's sight, He never uses this. He had another clock. It's called Kairos, God's time. And God will wait for time. Why? Because in His using of time, human time, He is actually forging character in our hearts. And that was what it's all about. Because when we realize, Lord, why did you really create us? You know, why did you create us in your image? Why is man or human beings so like you? We were created in your image and likeness. You know why God created us in His likeness and image? Because He created so many things around us. I know you love your cats and dogs, right? I'm a cat and dog person. But even though you love your pets, and you embrace the pet, you talk to the pet will not be able to talk to you and affirm you. Amen? They comfort you sometimes when you have problems. You don't see a dog talking to you, right? I mean, if you have deep personal things. That's why God said, I created you in my image and likeness. Because our emotions, our happiness, our loneliness, God also has the same. And when God wants to fellowship, He has angels, yes. They're so perfect. You know, most of them, two-thirds remain with Him, one-third became His enemies. Yet He looks at man and realizes, wow, I recreate myself. But the one thing we cannot be God. Amen? We may be God-like, but we cannot be God. So, He desires to fellowship with us. And that's what we do when we worship. Not only here. That's what we do when we talk to God in prayer. That's what we do when we kneel down in a closet, in a room, whether you're lonely sometimes or God will just stop you one moment and tell you, worship me. You know why? Because if human beings long for relationship, long ago, it will take you much money to talk to someone across the world. For example, I called Paul in Canada. That would cost me so much, Paul. But now I could just, you know, at my fingertips, I can talk to you. Real time. But why is it that the more human beings are so interconnected? There are 28 powerful GPS satellites on top of us. They can detect any human movement within a millimeter. That's why when military use that for surveillance, huli ka na kagad. They'll really get you. Because those are very powerful, powerful telescope. Some people call it the Big Brother. Diba? Everything you do can be seen from up there. People are trying to be like God. But yet in the period and time when there was so much communication, when you could just type a name for information, you can Google it. Everybody knows everybody, but do you know what? It's just basic information. Does everybody really know everybody? I don't think so. A lot of people said this is one of the loneliest ever generations in the world. Well, we think we're so interconnected. That thing we call the computer, I have nothing against it. I may not be a techie. It's so useful. But sometimes people talk to a computer without really talking face to face with a person. Long ago, it was not like that. It's still a green screen, right? Right? During those times, they call it fax machine. And people say, oh, it's good that we have fax machine. I can really, you know, connect, do business with people. But somebody told me, yeah, that's good. We have fax machines. But you cannot say, but one of my friends says, you know, it's good we have fax. Fax is something laughable now. Right? I mean, you can have everything at your palm. Your cell phones, your smartphones are powerful. You have everything added and placed at your fingertips. When I was saying my thesis before, I said, one day you'll have cell phones. What's a cell phone? Well, cell phones are phones in your hand. at that time, the groundbreaking thing was the pager, right? They have two pagers, busy call and racket bell. They said it's easy call, but when you call it, it's busy. Pocket bell, it's racket bell, because you pay less service. And yet people are happy. We have phones back then, nasa line. But when you call, somebody's talking, hello party line, pwede pakibaba? Can I talk to my friend? You've been talking for the last 3 hours? You have party line. You know, when Lee Kuan Yew was here long ago, we said, you know, the Philippines, I am really proud of you. You know, you have phones, really, in your homes, but will take you 3 days to have a dial tone. They were laughing at us. But I was telling them the thesis, you know, one day cell phones will be analog, and from analog, sooner it will be digital, and all over the world, you'll be shocked that that phone will be at your finger. Flip phone. And it will be so thin that you don't need computers. No, before it's desktop. I told them one day it will be laptop. Why? Because it's here. Now it will be in your palms. Everything in your office, you don't need an office. You only have to have a cell phone. You'll be doing that in coffee shop. Everybody was shocked. Will that be true? And what we have is something that was seen long ago. But yet, the more we have it, the more we don't really talk. You see, one family, they're not talking, they have smartphones. And yet, that's bonding to them. And yet, we are losing people. We're losing people close to us. And we live in neighborhoods where you don't even know the person living next door. Amen? I used to ask people in GSIS, I used to know people living here. But do you know them now? No. I don't even know the person living next door. Why? Because that's always been a problem nowadays. They call it neighborhoods, but nobody knows who's living next door. Amen? They say, hey, what's more important than a journey is its destination. That's why some people said, I started badly. No, it doesn't matter if you start bad or slow or palpak. What matters is you finish well. Amen? Life will have an end. It's called destination. It's called destiny. You may have made palpak, big things. You blow it up. You may have big regrets. Forget about that. God loves you. He not only died for you, He's willing to start again, fresh, every day. So here we are. Like I said last Sunday, there were a lot of roads mentioned in the Bible. First was the road to Emmaus. Remember that? Two of those disciples walked with Jesus, bonded with Him at almost early evening. And yet, that stranger whom they walked, the third guy, was explaining to them about what happened during that week. And they were amazed. Wow! How would he know so much, not only revelatory things, but truth. But yet, when they reached their destination in Emmaus, they said, didn't our hearts inside was jumping? They realized it was the risen Christ. Hindi biro yung kasama nila. Imagine us having the privilege to walk with God. If they had that, God is alive today. I will assure you, God can walk with us. He's not just in heaven, He is here. And He can tell you things. Things in your heart, things that may have excited you, things that may have made you lonely, things that may have stopped you from being effective sometimes. Because God is so concerned about the issues that we have here. And yet most of the time we're very cerebral. We always think about a lot of things, but we're missing one point. Even though we're so far ahead with our imagination and plans, as long as God will not move our heart to be right with Him, plano lang yan. And even if we think it's advancing, the real joy will not come to you. And I think we can have the best of both worlds. Amen? The wisdom we need, and yet the love in our heart will go hand in hand with that wisdom. Not only to be blessed, but to be a blessing. There's another road which Pastor Dave preached. It's about Philip, the desert road, right? He said, Lord, I'm in Samaria. It's party time. It's fiesta time. It's revival time. Best things to do, stay there. Because you asked me to start it, but God said, it's okay. I'll give it to another. Follow me. He went to a road where no one seems to be passing. Surprisingly, there was a chariot, and that chariot had one of the topmost official of Ethiopia. And Bible says, even history will point out that that event, that encounter led to Christianity in that part of Africa. To this day, there is what we call the Coptic Church, not only in Egypt, but even in Ethiopia. It's alive. Church is alive in there. People may have a different way of celebrating things, but they still worship the Christ in Ethiopia. Amen? Kanya-kanya expression, same God, same Christ. That road to the desert led to Christianity in Africa. Another one would have been the road to Damascus. That was last week. Right? Paul, wanting to kill more people, wanting to put them in prison, having all the authority in his hand, was with the top officials of the high priest. Okay? This time, they went outside of Jerusalem, outside of Judea, into Damascus, another country. Because like Pastor Dave said, everybody that was, you know, na diaspora sila, they were like, they broke out because of Stephen's death. They ran away. And for Paul, who truly think I'm doing the will of God, he went there. That encounter changed him. It's called the road to Damascus. He fell from his high horse. Nabulag siya. Thank God for that. Paul became the 12th apostle. He wrote 2/3 of the New Testament. Our encounters with God in this journey of life really would change us. This morning, I will tell us about that parable and a story. Perhaps some people say it's a parable. Perhaps it's a true story. I put a title to this, The Road to Jericho. Pag inisip mo, ano meron doon, di ba? Jericho was part of an Israeli territory, part of Israel at the time, perhaps 18 miles from Jerusalem. And knowing the terrain of that land, less tree, rocky in all, and you realize, what do we have here? Let me just read this verse, Luke 10, 25 to 29. Then I'll go on. Okay, the parable of the Good Samaritan. So, we realize, okay, parable of the Good Samaritan. Di ba lumaki tayo, we grew up having all this? Let me just read that. Okay? On one occasion, an expert of the law stood up to test Jesus. Teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? What is written in the law? He replied. How do you read it? He answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. You have answered correctly, Jesus replied. Do this, and you will live. But he wanted to justify himself, so he asked Jesus, and who is my neighbor? I think it's time for us to understand. This is not just a simple question. Okay? One thing about these experts of the law, some of them may be Pharisees, some of them are just basically scribes. They really know the law. If it's here in this country, they call it, yung mga lolo ko, they call it abogado de campanilla. Okay? Yung talagang hindi mo basta matutwist. Some people who really knew the ins and outs and the inner workings of law and the courts. So he was asking Jesus because in their hearts, they felt so insulted that a non-insider, somebody who's really not from Jerusalem, someone who's really from the outside, okay, a son of the carpenter can outwit any one of them. So when Jesus came to Jerusalem from time to time, or even in some of the places where the Pharisees and the Sadducees live, even the priest, he would cause a stirring. because he would know what they know. And they were just so amazed. That's why they're beginning to give him a title, Rabbi, Teacher. Remember that? Most of the time, nire-reject ni Jesus yung calling na yung title eh, because it's not really about it. He was trying to tell these people, you know the law, now where are you in the law? I recall when I was a brand new Christian, because I was in Adamson before, talagang grabe yung lifestyle ko. But I was, me and my friends were known in Adamson. We were favorite of the dean. We're dean's listers. Not because we top the grade, but we are just the cause of headache for everybody. Okay? Every week, siguro, nakaka one or two visits ako sa office ni Dean Abigotero, J. Pag nakita na naman niya, he would shake his head. What? Again, this time, was just there. Then I came to know the Lord. And one of those guys from another, you know, religious thing, you know, one of those ultra-religious groups, would quiz a lot of people. Kasi during the time in the 80s, when you said, I'm born again, parang kakaiba yon. People, ano, born again? Parang kadiri yan, di ba? Parang, they felt, parang feeling mo, leprous ka ba? Parang kami ketong. People, I'm born again. So, when you become a Christian, people will either step away because that's my school, Adamson University. Okay? Ganong kalupit dun. They said there are very good Catholic universities in Manila. That was one of the good schools. Not because they're best in architecture. That's one of the toughest schools to be. Average is like 2 dead students every sem. Okay? 2 to 5. Depending on a good rumble. But they have very good people there. Very good students. But very violent. So here we are, living in a time where there was turmoil in this country. Marcos, Aquino, and all this. So we were there. I got to know the Lord. 2.5 weeks later, I was just so in love with Jesus, reading my Bible, okay, waiting for someone I want to share with, and there is this guy from one of the ultra groups there who went in and quizzed me a lot. So being a 2.5-week-old guy, I was like astounded. Why are you telling me? He was quizzing me, you know. I know this Bible, I read it like 10, 12 times, cover to cover. He was asking me things, bro, honestly, I don't know the answer to your question. Thank God you read it 10 times or 12 times, di ba? Cover to cover, wow. Including the maps, di ba? The only thing I know was that John 3:16, for God so loved the world. Yun lang sa akin eh, that's the only thing, I hold on to that. But he was just like full of pride hitting me because I know he did that to a lot of Christian newly saved people, and a lot of them got stumbled. He said, Lord, I just look at him with the heart of God. But I said, Lord, what will I tell this guy? He was so angry. He was trying to hit me hard with all these questions. Then I recall, he's fourth year, I'm second year. We were classmates with Rizal. Rizal is a minor subject. So I told him, well, thank God that you did that. You've read the Bible so many times. I wish I could be like you. But I had a question for him, bro. How much of that Bible is in your life? How much of it have you obeyed? He was silent. I said, you have 3 girlfriends. One of them was my batchmates. And yesterday we had Rizal. You cheated. You've been cheating all the long. And since I got to know the Lord, I stopped cheating. I think I see the difference. I love to be where you are, but how much of the law have you applied in your life? Because the only thing I know in the law was that for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. Yun lang alam ko eh. I was so happy with one scripture. It changed my life. I realized we have a problem here because this guy was trying to justify to Jesus his inability to reach out and love others. Inisip mo, Lord, ano to? So let me continue. When he asked that, Jesus, you know, when you go to Jesus, he will not be mad at you. He will love you. Even though that guy was trying to avoid in an argument to embrace the truth, he answered him. Jesus said, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road. When he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was, and when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. Look after him, he said, and when I return, I will reimburse you for any extra expense you may have. Wow. This is a common story we know, but there is a deep meaning to this one. You realize that many times, a lot of these experts of the law would go against Jesus. In the words of the Bible, they said they would try to test him. And I recall a scripture when Jesus was being tempted in the wilderness before he started his ministry. That was the way he rebuked Satan. Satan, do not put the Lord your God to the test. And sometimes you realize, Lord, why have they done that? Pero tanungin natin sarili natin. Ask ourselves, Lord, in our own life, have we ever tested you? Have you ever tested God? You know, God never wanted to be tested. The only test he said he would allow is in giving. So niya, test me in this. Will I not fill up your house with so much? Give you a tsunami of a blessing. Dun lang. In other ways, do not test him. They were trying to test Jesus. Because they were trying to do human knowledge ba? Expertise. Sometimes you look at them, they're lawyers anyway, but aren't we all lawyers? Lahat tayo abogado, di ba? Tama ba? Pakisabi sa katabi mo, abogado ka, no? We're all lawyers inside. I recall what Pastor Dave said. If somebody is guilty, we will be crying justice. Sobra yan! That man needs to be punished. But if we are guilty, we will quick to say, mercy. Grace. Why is it? Because that's the way lawyers would do. They can either make you guilty or free you up. But realize, Lord, it's not just the scribes or the expert of the law. We too are experts of the law. We may not have read that Bible cover to cover yet, but many times we were so good at justifying ourselves. You know, early on in my walk with God, the guy that pastored me taught me one principle. He said, Mel, sin is sin. You cannot justify sin. You can only repent when you sin. Because God died for your sin. You can never justify nor psychologize sin because sin caused God to go to the cross to die on our behalf. How many times have we justified sin? Amen? Lord, konti lang naman to eh. And yesterday, that was the topic, forgiveness. You know how heavy it is for all of us? That's why most of the times as we walk in this life, Kristiyano man tayo o hindi pa, we find it so vague to understand God. Because there were 3 things that come against us, 3 things we placed in our way. First, there were lies that were taught us growing up. And to this day, even if some people are Christian, we've embraced that lie to be true. Second, there were hurts growing up that people gave us through words, through actions. Those hurts, when remain unforgiven, will cause you to really see God vaguely. Third, cursing. So there were 3 causes of sin and cursing. 1, perhaps you curse others. 2, perhaps others cursed you. 3, it may be generational. You may not know it, but the lolo of your lolo were practicing certain things like witchcraft, which is very common in the Philippines. So yesterday we were talking about it. You know, what stops us from knowing God? These things will cause us not to see God. And see, we have this guy trying to justify. Sabi niya, okay, who's my neighbor? Every time I share on this, I would always recall, sino nga pala? Because I know what my neighbor is, because when I was a kid, there was this favorite TV show I watched during around 8 or 9 a.m. It's called Sesame Street. And there's one Sesame Street song I will never forget, because that's a song where everybody will sing. I mean, Big Bird, Ernie, Bert, Cookie Monster. And they will, you know, in unison, they will walk around and say, who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood. In your neighborhood. And who are the people in your neighborhood? People that you meet each day. Diba? And you realize every character, well, a carpenter is the person in your neighborhood. Everybody's like, wow. Sometimes okay pa yung mga Muppets eh. They know. That's a carpenter. That's a policeman. People that you meet when you're walking on the street each day. Imagine this guy. He's so used to the law, but the one thing he forgot when Jesus asked him, how can I enter heaven? Remember, a lot of people ask Jesus this. Remember the rich young ruler? How can I enter heaven? He said the same things. Read the commandments to him. Said, okay, do love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. You know why they can say that automatically? Because in Israel, when kids will be prepared for the 13-year-old bar on bat mitzvah, yung mga babae tsaka batang lalaki, when they are used to saying, okay, you're already a man and a young woman. Okay? Starting at a very young age, they will be made to memorize scripture. And the first memory verse is Deuteronomy 6:4-6. Ayan yan, to love the Lord your God. So, imagine mo when you're that young and you memorize, when you become a lawyer, even in your dreams with eyes closed, you can memorize that. But it's a two-pronged law. To love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. And to love your neighbor as yourself. Who's my neighbor? Amen? Imagine Cain, after he killed his brother, where is your brother Abel? If you make his answer in a Filipino context, okay? Let's make Cain Filipino for a while, okay? Ito yung sagot ni Cain, kung Filipino siya. Bakit? Ako ba yung hanapan ng nawawalang kalabaw? Ganun yun eh. Am I my brother's keeper? Of course. Why will you call him brother if you're not his keeper? Napakaamot si Gagat was scratching. Am I my brother's keeper? Why do you call him my brother if you're not his keeper? We just killed him. Yeah, that's Cain and Abel. Yeah, but how many times did we really kill people? God said, you kill people. Yeah, I'm not a rapist. Yeah, you look at a woman with lust. You already committed adultery. What? Because in the old law, you have to do it. In the New Testament, thinking about it is doing it, because it's what we call now premeditation. When you're in courts of the law, they will not call how you do it. They will ask your motives. Bakit mo ginawa? Bakit? Amen? That's why one of my pastors before said, you know what? The deepest question is not how, when, where, who, and how, and what. The deepest question in life is why? Bakit? Diba? Bakit? Doon kayo iiyak eh. Kasi sino? Madali lang. Saan? Kailan? Paano? Ano? Pero pag sinabing bakit, malalim. Why? Why'd you do it? You're guilty of murder because before you can kill someone, you have to hate someone. Right? You don't just kill someone. Ay, sorry. Wrong person. You were hating people, whether you hit the right target or not, you're murderous. Nobody can stop your hand from, you know, from that trigger. In the eyes of God, we all violated the law. Men who will not be in full control of their mind by the Holy Spirit will keep lusting. So you look at adulterous people, if you hate it, you realize there's also a seed in your heart about it. Why do you hate somebody fallen into adultery? But do you have one? That's why Jesus said, okay, if nobody is guilty of one sin, please get the biggest stone and hit this naked woman. Kill her. I give you the full right. Nobody did. Nobody did. Because every one of us know, one way or another, we're guilty. Amen? Have we hold back? Not only giving, but love. That was what he's asking. Who is your neighbor? You're complete with the vertical. Love your God. Well, me and God, that's straight up. Walang problema eh. Who among you in this room will say, I hate God? No one will say. Kahit may tampo kay God, you will never say, I hate you, Lord. No. No. Because in our mindset as Filipinos, baka tamaan ako ng kidlat. Takot niya kagad. Kahit nagtatampo ka, di ba? So the vertical thing, there's no problem. This guy, like us, we have no problem with the vertical. Whether sometimes we do right or we do wrong, we always look to God. But God was saying, okay, no problem with the vertical. What about the horizontal, your neighbor? You and that person living next. Like I said, as people of the church, let's not make the Muppets of Sesame Street wiser than us, because they know the people in their neighborhood and we don't. Amen? It's time to see how powerful the word is in our heart by looking all around us and realize, Lord, I'll start with the church. Amen? That guy knew everything. What's the difference between us and him? He knew, he loved God. There's nothing in him and God in terms of the, perhaps the legal practice of loving God, he did that. But there's one thing deeper than legal. It's called love. Remember, the law was made for man and not man for laws. We're not saying tatapon natin yung laws. It's for the very reason na tayo, that's why they created laws. Because God loves us so much, He wants to protect us. Law is not something that is against man. Law protects. The law protects you. You know why they hate these people? Because Samaritans are mixed blood. Remember, there were, after Solomon, it was split into two kingdoms, Judah and Israel. The 10 tribes and the 2 tribes, Benjamin, half tribe of Manasseh, and Judah on the other. First to go was Israel, the capital of which is Samaria. Okay? The Assyrians carted the last kingdom in 727 and 722. 5 years ata yun. After that, it was nowhere. That's why it's called the 10 lost tribes of Israel. And just like any other conqueror of old times, what they do is intermix. When you conquer a land, you make sure that people from other lands will be there. And you also get the people from that land somewhere else. So you don't know who is who. Is this guy still Israelite? Does he still worship Jehovah? Did he intermarry or she intermarry with someone? We do not know. Times passed. 250 years later, Judah, with the capital Jerusalem, also went with Nebuchadnezzar. After the princes and kings were gone, the kingdom was not restored to its original. There was no king after Babylon. And the only thing that slept since that time, in the time of Persians and Babylonians, were the law. That's why when they returned, in the time of Ezra, okay, Nehemiah, and all those prophets of the return journey, since there is no official king, because that was the time when Alexander the Great, okay, the Persians, Alexander the Great, and the Romans came. Grabe yung nangyari. Those people of those empires really crushed the resistance in Israel. Yeah, they respect their existence, but there is no more an Israelite king. So to make sure a nation is intact with its faith, that's why a new breed of elites came. It's called the Pharisees and the Sadducees and the high priest. They're there to protect the identity of a nation. But too much protection led to them thinking that they're the only special people on earth, that God loves so much that they're the only one to be saved. They never care about the others. And the people they hate much was the Samaritans, because they know this is mixed race, mixed blood. Og na Pilipino pa ni mestizo ba? The word mestizo in Filipino are twofold. Mestizong puti, mestizong egoy, mestizong Chinese. Well, we were so intermixed. In Israel, if you're not a Jew, they hate you. In Filipino, if you're foreign, they love you. Sa atin, pag nalahian, sikat. Sa kanila, hindi. Pag nalahian, nasa ilalim ka. That's how they look at it. So these people hated the Samaritans. So the story went that a priest and a Levite went there. And this guy was beaten up for dead. And he made an example of that. Who is your neighbor? Simple question. Honest one. But the honesty is veiled on that attitude of saying, ayoko makialam. I take no part of it. Why? Because I have prejudice in my heart. They said that the opposite of love is not hate. Ulitin ko ha, the opposite of love is not hate. Kasi naman mo, pas, kung hindi hate, yung opposite ng love, ano yun? The opposite of love is not hate. It's called indifference. Indifference. You know what indifference is? It's a smoking gun. Pag sinabi mo smoking gun, may na-baril na, pumutok na eh. Pero walang sound kasi naka-silencer. Tumugo na lang yung tao. Somebody's blooded, he dropped dead. Who shot him? I've never heard a shot, but I can smell a smoking gun. Indifference is like that. You don't have to totally hate a person when you're so indifferent. You really don't love the person. Hate is always in the surface. Indifference is hidden inside. Fire that you can see outside can be extinguished. Indifference is like the lava inside the volcano. Hindi mo nakita, but it's hotter than the sun. This guy was so indifferent that the only defense he had to hide the indifference was to say, who's my neighbor? Sino nga ba? It's short of saying, do I really care? Right? So Jesus knew his heart. He gave this story. He made two characters na talagang the scribe or the teacher of the law would respect. Una, yung priest. Why? The priest is seen so high up in the community as the pillar. Pangalawa, the priest is the gatekeeper of people's salvation. Remember? Diba? They teach, they preach. Alam si Nicodemus? He said, Lord, how can I go to heaven? And Jesus said, you are a teacher in Israel. You don't even know. Unless you're born again. Oh, mubalik ko sa tiyas nanay na ko. You don't understand. It's not about physical birth. It's something that's within man that had to come out to be born in the world. So much. Ulitin ko, we may love God, and that is not really a problem to us. But when God look back to our hearts, does He see the same love for man? Do you really care? Some people will equate this, kailangan mag-evangelize. It's more than evangelism. It's kindness. That's why Jesus said, I was in prison, I was sick, I was naked, I was hungry, I was thirsty. You fed me. What? Lord, when were you sick? When were you hungry? Whatever you did to the least of my brothers, you do to me. Brothers, they say charity begins at home. We are brothers. We are sisters. You know, the world changed before because in the church of Christ, the first Christians, walang needy person doon. When you say walang need, it's more than the food and the money. The real need of people is not physical, it's relational. That's why they keep praying, because those prayers keep people from falling down. If you said malupit yung Rome, yeah, so is today's life. We may not have marching armies, but the same thing that affects human lives in their time affects our lives. Amen? So you look at it, Lord, who is my neighbor? The priest. That's his job. He's responsible for the temple worship and the ritual. The thing about the priest is that he is at that afternoon traveling back to Jericho. So priests have duties to do in Jerusalem at the temple. So it's like saying, if he's working in Jerusalem or he had a business there that day, he was about to go home. So he's not busy, di ba? A lot of us will say, oh, di ko katabang ni mo. I cannot help you because I'm too busy. This guy is going home. He's not busy. He saw the man, you know, try to pretend he walked the other side of the way. Hindi mo lang niya chinek if he's still breathing or dead. The next guy was a Levite. Levites are from the clan of Levi, right? I mean, they are people who are great help to the worship at the temple. And everything that's in there, they're the ones in charge. Perhaps he also lived in Jericho. Tapos na eh. I think it's 5 p.m., di ba? You have a bandi clock, 8 to 5, 9 to 5. Uwi na to. Not in a hurry to go home. Right? God was speaking to us. It's not about, this is already in the afternoon. Sometimes we have that reason, nagmamadali ako, marami akong gagawin eh. But these people, and most of us, sometimes when we reflect, there are moments in our life that really have time on our side, but we deny the love for people. Why? Because you always claim to be busy. Amen? Long ago in New Belt, in the church where I belong, there was this guy na kinukulit yung kaibigan niya always. That 3 days, she was being asked by this person, but yung her roommate in the dorm, a lot of things, asking things. She seems to be so confused. But she was like saying, I'm busy, but actually she's not. Turned out that on the night of the third day, she hung herself. Dead. In the dorm. Can you imagine the face of my Christian friend? I don't know if she felt condemned or what. She felt so bad. She was crying. She was knocking. What's the reason? Marami tayong ginagawa sa church. Things can do. People can do what you're doing. God was knocking at your hearts. Perhaps you were the last line of defense before that friend of yours in the dorm commit suicide. She had problems. You're just simply too busy. Amen? And we go back not only to neighbors. Let's go back inside the house. Let's not be too busy. Because that excuse has been so abused already. Amen? Let's also realize that there are a lot of people in need, even within your homes. Let the Holy Spirit and your heart listen to that. And the people you know, your friends, sino ba neighbors natin? Marami. If you're a student, that's your classmate. If you're working in the office, that's your office mate. If you're a businessman, that's your compadre, the one you always do business with. Amen? If you're a single guy or girl, that's the person you always hang out with. If you're a kid, that's the kid you always play with. We live in a world that's running after time, but do we really have time? Amen? The one question he gave, sino talaga yung neighbor ko? So the priest never did it. But the Samaritan, the one they hate so much, the one whose race they hate, took mercy and compassion. You know the man he helped? He's a Jew. Problem with Jews is that God commanded Jews to take care of each other. There's even a rule. The priest would have said, I cannot help this guy because I'm a priest. He never check if he's dead or alive. He presume he's dead. You know why the priest kept away? Because as a priest, he have priestly rules to stay away from a dead body. Okay, let's look at Leviticus. Tinan mo natin ito. Leviticus 21. There's a rule for priests. The Lord said to Moses, speak to the priests, the sons of Aaron, and say to them, a priest must not make himself ceremonially unclean for any of his people who die, except for a close relative such as his mother or father, son, daughter, brother, or an unmarried sister who is dependent on him since she has no husband. For her, he may make himself unclean. He must not make himself unclean for people related to him by marriage and so defile himself. What a rule. That's good. Right? You realize, okay, but you know what the Bible says? Human life precedes purity loss. That's a purity law. Plus, Bible says, if an Israelite is dead, bury him quickly in a day. He's your brother. Ganun yun. Kasi like, in a road to Jericho, that guy died alone. Wala kang relative. And surely you would know who he is. He's Jew. Help him. Why? Because there's also a rule among them that a dead Jew needs to be buried. It doesn't care about the purity rites anymore. Because that's the rule. A brother died with no one there, make sure he is buried. Because it's always the human life and the care for the human body that always is above purity rites. Ano ba yan? That's why sinabi ni Jesus, the law was made for men and not men made for laws. Pag naintindihan natin yun, ma-realize natin, the law was really not harsh the way we think of it. It's really filled with that love for all of us. So we see this, that these people in the same attitude, no, that's why they don't want to go straight even to Samaria, another region there, because they hated them. So the Jews, when they traveled from Peter's district, Galilee, to Jerusalem, they would either take Perea by the Jordan or the other side near the Mediterranean. They won't go straight. Although yun ang shortcut. But Jesus was breaking rules, right? Remember the Samaritan woman? He went straight to Samaria. Sabi ng babae, ba't kita bibigyan? I mean, you're a Jew, I'm a Samaritan. We don't drink the same. We don't worship the same. And yet, Jesus broke traditions by going straight in a shortcut because he realized, what would I take long time to travel when I can travel and touch lives? Amen? Jesus was so the kind of guy na talagang sasadyain ka niya. Deliberate siya ba? As we see this, we realize, Lord, the preservation of people's life, even the human body, takes precedence over all purity laws. And that's what the priest and the Levites forget. They ignore the guy. I was watching, and I shared it during Awake one time, a movie. Have you watched Bucket List? That's a movie of two guys who had cancer. Two guys who have terminal cancer. Mamatay na talaga sila. Okay? They made a bucket list. The bucket list is the last thing you list before you die. And since they're about to die quickly, they're may cancer na sila, they were listing things. They want to travel here and there. And they write things, you know. When they said, they listed to see something majestic while on top of the pyramid. In Egyptian eternity, when a man dies, the God they meet will ask them two questions. One, first question, have you found joy in your life? The next question is, have you brought joy to the lives of others? If you can answer that well, you will enter into an Egyptian eternity. Funny, because the concept of heaven is the same in every culture. Somebody asks you. There was a pastor that wrote a book about people who went to death and then was revived. Amen? Yung alam mo na matay na, nag-flatline, tapos bumalik. In their experiences, they met Jesus. All of them common. And they were asked one question. You know what that question is? It's not what you did in life. It's not the accomplishment. But have you loved others? All common. One word, one question. Have you loved others? Why is it that even when you enter eternity, the word love is being asked of you? Because that's the one thing he taught, I'm good with the vertical and bad at the horizontal. No. If you think you're good with that, the vertical guy will ask you, have you ever loved people? Have you found joy in your life? Have you brought joy into the life of others? Isipin mo, Lord, sumaya ba yung mga tao? Paano ba sasaya yung mga tao? Kasi mahal mo sila eh. Are you happy because you're so, you know, provided financially? Or you can just buy cars left and right? It's not. That will not make you happy. You will not carry it to eternity. It's always relationship. So he was asking this guy, relationship, hey, do you know your neighbor? Okay? Do you know your neighbor? Ayaw talaga niya sagutin. So you realize, Lord, to him, it's a good discussion thing. Who's my neighbor? Okay? Sobra sila exclusive. Yung mga magnanakaw naman, they see the guy worth exploiting. Kaya nga binugbog nila eh. So the religious guys, the priest and the Levite, that's a problem they want to avoid. Okay? The innkeeper, it's big business. Paying customer. To the Samaritan, he saw that wounded guy as a human being worthy of love and care. That's a question to us. Lord, ano ba talaga? Before we go, can I read these two scriptures? Matthew 5:17. They were so fearful about what Christ was doing, they asked him. And Christ answered, do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come to not to abolish, but to fulfill them. Why? Because you may know it, but since you're not doing it, you fall short. Amen? The scribe fulfilled 50%, but that's not God's score. God wants 100. You love him, that's 50%. You love others, that's 50%. That makes the entire love for God. Secondly, was this, Romans 13:8. Let no debt remain outstanding except the continuing debt to love one another. For whoever loves others has fulfilled the law. Let's just look at our hearts. I mean, Lord, what have we done in terms of really touching your heart? If we want your attention, you only require one thing, for us to care. Amen? Pastors are here, leaders are here, but you know what? For every Christian, that's what God requires. For us to love people. And the best people to love are the people who you considered enemies. Sino dito may enemy? Hindi si devil, ha? Kalaban talaga natin yung forever. So dito may enemy. Yung alam mo may mga haters saka bashers ka. You know, there are a lot of people who will hate you. In this world, expect that. That's a promise. God said, things that will cause men to stumble are bound to come. I ask God, Lord, is that a warning? Yes, but it's also a promise. Because most Christians would say, Lord, bless me, heal me. But God said, things that will cause you to stumble are bound to come into your life. It's a promise. Why? Because God is more concerned with character than just us being blessed. Real blessing is having a great character. Amen? You don't have to work so hard for others to love you. Love others. You'll reap love. Bakit? Kasi yun ang tinanim mo eh. Amen? Itatawa na kami ni Mark kahapon. Sabi ko ngayon, na-redeem ko na yung kanta ni Andrew E. Bakit? Kasi sabi nila, when you have an enemy, dahil galit siya sa'yo, pumapangit siya, he becomes ugly. Right? If you hate him back or her back, you become like her or him. You become also ugly. So in the eyes of God, sabi ko, i-redeem natin yung kanta ni Andrew. Ano yun? Humanap ka ng pangit. Ha? Oh, yung pangit, yun yung mga galit sa'yo eh. Kung pangit sila because of their hate. Ang sabi ko, humanap ka ng pangit, ibigin mong tunay. Hindi ito physical na pangit. Yung mga spiritual na pangit, yung galit talaga sa'yo, kahit anong gawin mo. Gawin mo yung tama, may puna pa rin sa'yo. Ano, may maraming tao, pintasero, pintasere. Smile at them. Even if you did your best, Paul, and people will just, you know, spit on the other side. Love them. He said, Lord, what about my rights? Yeah, you have one right, and that right is to love that person. Even as a pastor, it took me long to understand that. I thought I knew it like this guy, until you tell me things throughout these last 3 years that made me change my heart about people who really loves to hit you, not only to hate you, but to hit you. Amen? So it's not the physical pangit, it's the spiritual pangit. It's the people that hate. They love to hate. You know why they hate? Because they have been so hurt inside, they want to give you that hurt. Now it's up to you to receive the hurt or to smile back and say, no thanks. Okay? I have one thing to do and convince you, stop hating. I'll teach you how. Love him. He hated me so much. Everything he think was my distraction. So is the devil, but this is a person. Love him. Because in the heart of God, he still wants to make sense with this man, this woman, and save him or her. Amen? Luke 10:36. So after sharing that, tinanong ulit siya ni Jesus, which of these three, that's Luke 10:36, do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell in the hands of robbers? After he told that story, what do you think with that guy who knew the law? Imagine niyo yung mukha niya. Hindi siya makatingin kay Jesus. Because he was trying to justify himself. After showing that story, perhaps the Lord looked at his eyes and asked him this question. Which of these three was a neighbor? Helplessly, that is his answer. The expert of the law replied, the one who had mercy on him. Jesus told him, go and do likewise. Imagine mo hanggang sa dulo. Even at the end, he cannot even mention it's the Samaritan. He hates those guys so much. He can't even mention it's the Samaritan. It's never the priest. It's never the Levite. It's the Samaritan. But even that, he won't even say it's the one who had mercy on him. He cannot even name the guy. But you know what? Jesus was never angry. Look with mercy on the scribe, the teacher of the law, and said, go and do likewise. Why? Because you're talking to me about one day seeing me in heaven, I will require you of one question. Have you been kind? Have you loved your neighbor? Okay? One last verse, that's Galatians 5:22-23. It says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things, there is no law. Wow. Wow. Pag naisip mo, Lord, inuna niya yung love eh. Of all the fruit of the Spirit, sabi niya, that is the embodiment of Christ-likeness. You know, every day when God prays for us in heaven, I think He's really praying to God the Father, Dad, make your people become like who I am. Perfect in their character, these seven things. He put love first. Because if you had all those seven things, those seven fruits, you will never even reason from the law. Yes, you keep the law. But love will always be higher than the law given to them. I don't know how many you'll reach. You may reach 100 or even a 10 or one person. It doesn't matter. There's always a man like that fallen somewhere. A girl like that fallen somewhere. And if we just look with God's eyes, then we will never ever justify our lack of action. Because when you do love, you lose track of time. Right? When you practice love, you won't look at your clock or the calendar. You'll just love people. Because one day we'll be in the presence of God, we'll be so soaked with that love, but let's experience it while here on earth.